How did Rigby become everyone's favorite?
Well, about a week ago, I made a video about how Rigby was the absolute worst. It's here if you want to check it out, or the link will be down in the description below.
I'm not being contradicting. I did state earlier in the video that Rigby definitely redeemed himself towards the later seasons, so don't grill me in the comment section. So Rigby, where do we begin? You're a raccoon. But in all seriousness, Rigby wasn't the best character early on. Now, that doesn't mean Mordecai is off the hook. Mordecai is horrible. But that doesn't mean characters can't develop. Rigby early on was selfish, rude, lazy. Well, still lazy, but you know, you get it. Self-centered, egotistical, obnoxious. Wait, so how does he actually redeem himself? Well, I'm gonna get right to it right now. First, I feel like I have to mention Mordecai being one of the reasons. Over the years of watching, you can't help but notice Mordecai's behavior towards Rigby. Let's start at the fact that Mordecai loved playing punchies, knowing he could beat Rigby every time. Or when he killed Rigby over messing up his date with Margaret.
I'll kill you!
Mordecai was really the center of attention. He put his own feelings over Rigby, and we saw that. We saw that he valued relationships, whether it was with Margaret or CJ. We saw how that meant more to him than Rigby. Mordecai was a simp, but hey, that's a whole nother video. His constant behavior towards Rigby helped us as viewers better sympathize with Rigby. Now, I'd be remiss if I didn't speak on Eileen. Eileen initially just had a crush on Rigby, as revealed in the episode Do Me a Solid. At first, he thought nothing of her, and he tried to avoid her as much as possible. But in later episodes, Rigby has hinted that he might like Eileen back. This relationship is very significant in the personal growth of Rigby. In the episode Eileen Flat Screen, it is revealed that the duo actually hangs out quite often when Mordecai is busy doing work. They even went to a fair together off screen. In the episode, Rigby displays what even Mordecai notes is as unusual degree of responsibility and consciousness for him as he sets up Eileen's new flat screen TV for her. And he sets up the television and pizza delivery as an elaborate surprise for Eileen, which makes her blush when she finds out Rigby was behind it all. Overall, the episode revealed that their relationship is growing and that Rigby may like Eileen more than just a friend. In the episode Dumped at the Altar, Rigby tells Mordecai that he and Eileen are dating and that they have been for a couple months now, and also states that since then, he has been very happy.
For like a couple of months now. We have matching bracelets!
Dude, that's crazy!
In the episode titled The Eileen Plan, Rigby feels like he isn't smart enough to be dating Eileen. So he goes back to high school to graduate and get his diploma. But Eileen gets upset when Rigby keeps canceling their dates. So she finds him and becomes extremely mad. Rigby tries to explain to her that he was just trying to get his diploma for her, and she is touched that he did this for her. And Rigby says that he will still try to get his diploma for him and for her. Now, this next episode is crazy. In the episode Rigby Goes to Prom, this is a very important episode to note, as we learn about our next reason, Rigby's parents. Rigby needs a car to take Eileen to the prom, and he is turned down by everyone he asks. Don tells Rigby he could ask their dad for his prized car, to which Rigby refuses, but the two end up going to dinner at their parents' place in order for Rigby to ask. Barbara, Rigby's mom, is happy to have her sons over for dinner, unlike Sherm, Rigby's dad, who assumes Rigby is only there because he needs something. During dinner, Rigby tries to talk about how he's about to graduate high school, and he finally asks Sherm for his car. Sherm screams at him, saying that he can't borrow his car. Rigby yells at him, saying that he cares more about the car than he cares about him. Sherm sends Rigby to his room. Yeah, because he still lives there, right? No. And after he leaves, he tells Don to go on about his week. Barbara sighs and she goes up to Rigby's room, which is now a walk-in closet, to consult him, even bringing tissues with her. She gives him the keys to her husband's car, telling him not to scratch it or tell Sherm that she was even involved. Later that night, Rigby and Eileen are at the prom and have left with some of Rigby's old school friends to go out to Lookout Point. Sherm and Barbara are in bed. Sherm is trying to fix a tiny TV, and when he does this, he yells at it saying, why can't it be like the big TV downstairs? Pretty much signaling, why can't Rigby be like his brother, Don? Barbara tells him that she believes he's implying something else, which of course he was, but he just ignores her. Sherm then discovers that Rigby took his car. Enraged, he goes to the high school in a tank top and his underwear. Yeah, poor Rigby. And angrily asks everyone where Rigby is. He learns where they are, and when he arrives, he tells Rigby and Eileen to get in the car. As he drives, he tells Rigby that he's nothing but a screw-up and that he messes up everyone's lives and that he'll eventually find a way to ruin Eileen's life. Like, that's messed up, not gonna lie. Sherm is not paying attention to the road, and as he does this, he veers off the road and the car is about to fall off of the cliff. Rigby tries to take the wheel, but Sherm refuses. Rigby says that even if he does end up successful, he'll always care more about the car than he cares about him. Sherm lets Rigby take the wheel and he saves them, but the car is damaged by crashing when it falls and the rocks falling on it. Sherm tells Rigby he's proud of him and that he's allowed to drive the car. But right after saying this, the car gets totaled by a huge boater randomly crashing onto it. In Rigby's graduation day special, Rigby's parents and brother attend his high school graduation. Sherm complains about how he had to put on a suit for this, but Barbara shushes him. They all cheer for Rigby when he gives his speech, and his dad expresses that he's proud of him. As they all head towards the party with everyone else, they see the park randomly goes up in space and they all appear to be very worried for Rigby. In the finale though, after the park returns after being in space for about 3 years, Rigby's parents and brothers cut through the crowd and hug Rigby. Sherm looks proud of Rigby as he points to him and says something to the crowd, while Rigby looks flattered. Talk about development. And thus, Rigby was redeemed. You know he wasn't a saint, but I could tolerate him more than Blue. And that was how Rigby became everyone's favorite. Felt like I was just blabbering on and on. But anyway, hey, you stayed till the end? I appreciate you. I definitely do. What are your thoughts on Rigby? Share them in the comments down below. And if you enjoyed the video, like it and subscribe for more.